name is Pamela Baron, and I am a watercolorist living in Oakland, California. And I've been doing watercolor since I was in college. When I was at the Rhode Island School of Design, I was lucky enough to get into their study abroad program, and I lived in Rome for about 3 months. And when I was in Rome, I first actually got introduced to watercolor, and I walked into their art supply store there, and in my very butchered, broken Italian, asked the man what his favorite type of art supply was in his whole store. And he kind of looked at me, and then he gave me some watercolor. It was like a pan of watercolor, and I was kind of hooked ever since that. I'm incredibly inspired by travel. That's a key part of what I'm up to all the time. Whether it's just walking around my neighborhood or visiting a nursery or, you know, it's usually, yeah, I'd say almost all the things that I paint are things that I've, you know, had an experience with or encountered or documented. One of my first jobs when I moved back to California was I was in the Castro and I was walking two dogs and I walked them 3 times a day. And it was great because I got to see so much of the city and it was very inspirational. So I started documenting with my phone all the houses that were around me because I started painting them. And that was kind of the birth of my house series. I'm obsessed with documenting, you know, and I really like observing things and, you know, seeing what people are up to and how they individualize their spaces. And like, I guess I really resonate with the love and attention that people bring to their homes. A lot of the details that you'll find in the houses are actually details that I'm seeing. Like one of my favorite houses that I saw in Oakland, it has like a plastic parrot hanging from like the entranceway. And I didn't make that up. That is real. There is a house out there and it has a plastic parrot and it is just hanging out. Like, you know, and I just feel like that really needs to be, you know, celebrated. Like that's awesome. You know, and I think people, I don't know. Really key, especially when you know you're a freelance artist and you're kind of secluded in your studio a lot. It's been a funny journey self-promoting as an artist because it's not something that comes instinctually to me. And I think having that community of artists to kind of like, you know, hold your hand a little bit or give you the confidence to be able to go out and put yourself out there, make a line sheet, you know, make a cute little package for them to open up and see your work. And it's been so helpful to have great artist friends to be like, you can do this, and, you know, giving you the confidence to do things and put your artwork out there. I think one of my favorite things, thanks to Instagram, is when people come up to me at craft fairs and they're fans. They're like Instagram fans, and then I get to meet them in real life to know that your work is in their house and that they appreciate it and that it resonates with them. That's the best.